Hello everyone, it's me Preeti from Pretty Arts. Today we are going to draw a dotted mandala using household items. Trust me, it was my first attempt and it's very easy. Let's get started. So I'm going to draw a mandala on this cup. I broke the handle and I'm going to draw it on the blank side. So we are just going to replant the plant because we need that. And then let's get started with our mandala. We are going to use acrylic paint for this job. Then we are going to use the saw sticks. I didn't really use them. Then the Q-tips, toothpick, a pop socket for the center. We're going to remove the other side of the toothpick to create smaller dots. Now comes the main part. Take acrylic paint, dip it in some water, and cover your Q-tip with that acrylic paint so that the Q-tip edge will be smooth enough to create dots with it. Don't worry about the frizzes. If you have any, just take more acrylic paint and then just cover it up. Now I'm using the pop socket to create the center. This pop socket was of no use, so I decided let's just make something good with it. We are going to stamp the pop socket on the cup to create the center. Of course, it's not going to be perfect in first attempt. Just mix it match somewhere and then you'll get what you want. So I'm extremely sorry, I did not film the green part, but we are going to do the same using the yellow one with the toothpick. And always remember, keep a damp cloth beside you so whenever you do a mistake, you can undo it. Now I'm going to use a Q-tip, dip it in acrylic paint and then just dot it on the mug. So these dots will be bigger than the toothpick ones. Here's a quick fix if you mess up. Just take your Q-tip, dip it in water and just clean it off. It's acrylic paint, so it's going to be coming off easily as it's temporary. So now I'm just using the Q-tip to create more bigger dots. Yes, you can do this with different dotting tools, but I'm doing this using household items. So what do you do to create more dots? It's put a dot in the middle and then just squish or move your Q-tip around so that you create a bigger dot. Okay, so I'm just using normal temporary acrylic paint. What it means that if I scratch accidentally this design, it's gonna come off. It's not porcelain paint, it's not a paint by QB products, it's not a permanent paint. What that means is permanent paint is designed to be permanent. What you do is you color that paint on some object or something like that which is microwave safe, and then you put that object in a microwave at a desired temperature, and that design becomes permanent. But those paints are also different. You'll have to keep in mind that every paint has different temperatures of in the microwave, so you just read the instructions and then proceed. Do not put normal acrylic paint in the microwave, please. Before doing something, do some research and then only execute that thing. So now I'm just adding bigger dots using a Q-tip with a different color. Dotting mandalas are just a mix and match thing. It's just depend on your head, on your creativity. I didn't have a color scheme over here right now. This was my first attempt. It's my raw attempt, but it's actually pretty good. So now we are going to take a toothpick and add a dot on top of the yellow one, the center dot first, and then drag the dots around that yellow dot. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. So I'm just going to do the same thing that I did with the orange dots. Create a dot in the center and then drag the dots around the center. So now I'm adding pink dots in the center of the petals to add more design to it. So I'm squishing or moving the Q-tip around to make the dot even more perfect and a little bit bigger than the yellow ones. Now I'm just adding green dots in the middle of the pink ones using Q-tips. Now I'm adding the blue dots above the green dots. I'm doing them a little bit smaller because we're gonna add different design in between. And don't worry about it overlapping the cup design. That part is definitely not going to be visible. So I would suggest using a plain cup or a mug rather than something with a print on it. But this was my idea of creating something beautiful out of this broken mug. So I think it works pretty good. I'm using the other side of the Q-tip and adding a white dot above the blue one. And now I'm going to just drag the dots as we did with the yellow dots, but using a toothpick. So now I'm using the other end of the Q-tip and adding three dots, two being at the same level and one which is in the middle should be higher. Now I'm dragging these dots using a toothpick, just as we did for the yellow and blue petals or dots. So that's pretty much it. You can increase this design, but I thought this was enough and it looks beautiful. I'm happy with it.